I'm looking at the belt tensioner for the rotary head. This was the one in the MDF version. It consisted of a bearing and a sleeve, and into this sleeve was a bush with a bolt hole, offset bolt hole, so you could move the bearing in and out, and this would take up the tension on the belt. This one is made for automotive, for a cam belt, and it's quite a big bearing. So what we're doing today, I'm using the same inside, which is the aluminium with the offset hole. I'm making it fit a new bearing, and we're making a sleeve for the bearing so that the belt can be held between the sides of the sleeve and run in the middle. It will give it some guidance. So let's go into the workshop and see how we make it. So the stepper motor will come through here, the pulley will be there. This was the tensioner that I used before, which is far too big. I found this bearing, so what I'll do is modify the offset so that fits the bearing. So once I have the belt fitted across the two, I can then position the centre hole for this so that I can put tension on the belt. It doesn't need a lot of tension being a tough belt. So just to get this block set in the right position, I've scored a mark in the centre, and I'll use the centre in the tailstock until I can get this lined up. So for now I'll just hold it in the chuck. By using this centre as a guide, I can see which way I have to move the chuck jaws to get the centre lined up with the cross. By slackening the chuck jaw one side and tightening up the jaw on the other side, I can move the center position of the plastic so that it aligns with the center in the tailstock. I'll just adjust the plastic so it protrudes out of the chuck jaws a small amount to allow me to face the plastic off once I've bored the hole. I'll just check that all the chuck jaws are tight before I start to machine. I've just drilled a 10mm hole in the plastic for the boring tool to pass through. That's about 1.3. Mm-hmm. be that size. You can see it's just going in. Finishes a little bitter. I'll leave that as it is. So I've finished in the 4-jaw chuck. I'll swap that now for the 3-jaw. So at the moment I'm using a parting off tool to go in and form a recess, and I'm hoping to get that recess. I want that recess the same width as the belt. Okay, go a bit deeper. So what diameter is this? Two inch. Belt fits that okay. Make it a little wider on the slot. Do next is just put a slight chamfer each side so that the belt will go into the centre. take that out, turn it round, finish off the outside. So now I've just put the bearing in there. Beans that are off machine such a lot off this, the plastic is a bit flexible. The bearing's gone in and it's holding. So it's only a guide. The belt, it won't be the teeth that go into the slot, it's going to be the back of the belt. Made it just a bit wider so there's play in there, so any, if it's off centre slightly, it'll still do the job. So that's a tensioner. So that was the old one I was using. The new one is slightly smaller, but it now has got the proper guide for the belt. And also I'm going to put this, press this in here. We've then got the offset on the cam for the tension. I'll press this in the vise. This is the back of the rotary head. And this is where the belt will be when I put the spindle in, with the stepper motor in the corner. Now this is the part we've just made. This is a plastic belt guide, the bearing, and then through the centre I've got this aluminium piece, which is an offset hole. The idea of this is it will go onto the belt. I have to adjust the height, could go either way. It will go onto the belt, lock into the belt there, and then when I've set the position, I'll drill a hole through. The bolt will go through the hole and hold the adjuster to the back plate, and then by turning this on the bolt, it will release tension or put more tension on this belt. Now you can see there the difference between the MDF one and the aluminium one. On the prototype, the MDF is 20 millimeters thick, so on the aluminium one I only need it to be 10 millimeters thick, so that's reduced the height in about 20 mil and the width by the same. It's reduced my area to put the belt, so I've got to be more accurate with the positioning of the belt, and that's why I had to redo the tensioner to make it a little bit smaller. Well, that's the tensioner finished. I hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.